Hello everyone, I am Dr. Sirajul Afaizi. I welcome you in my YouTube channel. Today in this video, I am going to talk about flame photometer. You know, flame photometry is instruments and it is very useful. So, today we will learn about the flame photometer. So, we have the contents today. I will give the introductions about the flame photometer. Then I will discuss about the history, then I will discuss about the electron, orbital and energy state, then I will discuss about the principle, then I will discuss about the instrumentation, then I will discuss about simple introductions, then I will discuss about the burners and flame, then I will light on mirrors, then I will light on monochromators, then I will light on detectors. Then I will give the information about applications and then I will focus on interferences. Then in the last, I will discuss about the limitations of this instrument and flame photometer. So let us start with the introductions. You know, my friends, flame photometer or flame atomic emission spectroscopy. It is a type of emission spectroscopy where atomic emissions is measured using a spectrophotometer. When metallic species is introduced into flame, the metal salt is burned emitting certain colored wavelength, and this instrument is based on the measurement of intensity of color. Each metal gives characteristic color and the intensity of color depicts the amount of quality of metal presence. Hence, the identifies the presence of or absence of metal via flame photometer. What is the history? You know, the history of spectroscopy starts with the use of the lens by Aristophanes about 423 BC and the studies of mirror by Euclid 300 BC and Hero 100 BC. In the later 18, scientists such as Kirchhoff's, Bunsen, Rowlands, Michelson's and Balmer studies the composition of sun based on their emission at different wavelengths. Then in February of 23rd, 1955, Murray Nielsen filed a patent for innovation of flame photometry, which was granted in year 1958. So, orbitals of electrons. Electrons of atom reside in concentric sphere known as energy shells, in which they orbit the nucleus of an atom. Each shell is assigned a principal quantum number n. The value n is integer 1 to 3. This number determines the relative energy of the orbitals and relates the distance from the shell to the nucleus. The lower the number of the lower the energy of the electrons and the closer it is to the nucleus. We all know that this is very basic chemistry. Electrons can be further distinguished according to their location in atomic orbitals, a specified regions in space that depends on their energy. So, my friends, all the electrons are in their respective lowest energy state, referred as the ground state or the state of the lowest energy. You know, a certain energy is provided to the atom and electrons from its residence, the ground state shell, to the higher energy state shell called excited state. As the excited state electrons are in the shell with greater n, hence they have more energy than less state. So energy levels of electrons, you know, E1, E2, then you have to calculate del E2 minus E1, that is del H nu. You know, the relations of del H nu is C by lambda. And if you want to calculate frequency, frequency is equal to, you know, C by lambda. So, energy difference, Planck constant, frequency of emitted light and velocity of light. Now, Boltzmann law. The fraction of free atoms that are thermally excited is governed by a Boltzmann distribution, n pi star divided by n del E exponential del E kT. N star is the number of excited atoms, N is the number of atoms remaining in the ground state, del E is the difference in energy levels, K the Boltzmann constant, T is the temperature. Now, what is the principle? Liquid simple containing metal salt solution introduced into a flame. Solvent is vaporized, leaving particles of solid state salt. Salt is vaporized into gaseous state. Gaseous molecules dissociate to give neutral atoms. The unstable excited atom emit photons while they return to the on lower energy state. The measurement of the emitted photons forms the basis of the flame photometry using photomultiplicity detectors. So you see the ground state, you see the excited state, and you see the emission, you see the absorption. So table showing characteristic wavelength and color. Sodium 589 yellow, potassium 766 violet, calcium 762 orange, lithium 770 red, barium 554 lime green. So instrumentations. So my friends, I will discuss about this part in my next video. So if you like this video, then subscribe my channel, and thanks for watching.